que no peito dos desafinados, no fundo do peito bate calado. No peito dos desafinados também bate um coração.
So, I moved, I got a teaching job in Denton, Texas, at University of North Texas. So I moved to Texas, across the state of Texas, to North Texas. And I, first thing I found out when I got to school there was, there was this thing called the Visual Resources Library. And no one was using this thing. So they said, okay, here's what I'll do. You can bring any book you have, and I'll scan all the material, and I'll make a website for you. And I'm kind of an obsessive collector of books. So I just started bringing them stacks of books. This is just one stack with all my little post-it notes of like, please scan this, 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 this. It would always say, this one, this one, this one, this one on it. And the idea was I was going to make something that was a teaching tool. And it was, so basically if a student had a question about a certain type of drawing or a certain type of image or a certain type of sculpture, I would have some kind of example. And these are just, this is just like if you tapped on the Maury Syndak page, like it would open up and there'd be like 35 images of different things that Maury Syndak had drawn in children's books. And then while I was there, I met this guy named Ed Blackburn. He's an artist that's been teaching there for almost 30 years. He's an amazing guy. He's about, I think Ed is probably 29 years older than me. But it was a really, it's like one of those friendships that you had when you were a child, like just this amazing friendship that we talk on the phone now. But we had dinner every Wednesday night for 4 years straight. And this is a picture of, I probably should have gone to this slide before I said the dinner point. But this is a movie he really likes called Court of Shadows by Marcel Carné. It's a really beautiful film. But he knows a tremendous amount about movies in general, and especially film noir. And it was an incredible, my friendship with him, it's just been an incredibly enriching learning experience. And we'd have these amazing dialogues. Have you ever seen My Dinner with Andre? Has anyone ever seen that film? So it was like My Dinner with Andre every Wednesday for me. So for some reason, we finished dinner one night, and I thought, you know, I'm just going to tell him how much I appreciate, like, his friendship. And he told me this story, and that I thought was really amazing. And I'm going to make a little collage, and I'm going to send it to him over the as an email. So he told me this story about when he lived in Abilene, Texas, and he was in high school. There was some kind of contest. It was like a plane flew over the city of Amarillo, and it dropped all these balloons with these little plastic, those things in like bubble gum machines. They have toys in them, but they had money in them. And he said that people were running all over the streets trying to get these things. And he sprinted down this alleyway, and for some reason there was a ladder. And he was able to climb on, he got this ladder, he climbed on the second story of this roof, and just hundreds of these balloons descended, and there was no one around. And he just said he was laughing and laughing. I just love the idea of this thing. It's beautiful. So anyway, I went back to my like collection of images, and I tried to put something together that I thought related to that story or kind of illustrated that story. So what you have is, on the left-hand side, you have what I started with, which is, it's a sculpture by Alexander Calder. It's called Ashtray for Saul Steinberg. And then on the bottom is an early Rauschenberg cardboard piece. So I just sort of edited these things and kind of created this thing. And his greatest compliment is, that looks just like the Panhandle. That's what he said when he saw this thing. So like one night we saw The Conformist, this Bertolucci film. And there's this great scene where a guy tosses a gun to another character. No Way Out is another film, but I like the way it looked in this collage. And I would start, so I mean, the sources were completely random, like those shoes that to me kind of indicated that it was an Italian, like nice shoes. That's from a Bill Woods photograph. And I think like the hand, this hand on the right and this hand on the left is from an Italian poster for The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly that I just cut pieces out of. And maybe that section is from a Japanese woodblock print. But I didn't consider these artwork. I just considered these things that I would send to my friend. This is another one. This is three scenes, three different movies from this movie called Le Samurai by Jean-Pierre Melville, which is a super cool movie about this guy that steals cars. This is a still from Michelangelo Antonioni's film, Zabriskie Point. I like this big salad bowl in the desert filled with money. It's a real dated movie, but it's a really great looking film. And it's kind of slow, but I'm not going to tell you what happens in the end, but you got to see the ending. So I saw this and I made this collage, these types of images and this type of film. It's a road movie of sorts. So then I moved we shared an office. And so it seemed ridiculous to send emails to a person you were sharing an office with. So I started like printing things out and putting them on his desk after we ate. Or this is before we're gonna go eat. So, dear Ed, I'm not golden today, but I will meet for dinner. My studio work is still not in a discussion stage. But typical of me, like I'm correcting my note to him. So move the words up 5/16 of an inch. Please move entire sentence 3/16 of an inch down. And this little character on the left-hand side, I made kind of stationary out of him. It's from a drawing by Ben Catcher. By the way, if you guys don't know who Ben Catcher is, he has this comic strip. Do you know Metropolis magazine? Anybody know that magazine? An architecture magazine, and the back page is always one of his comics, but they're amazing. And if you can find this book called Julius Knipple, Real Estate Photographer, buy it. And then the letters started getting longer. I think this is some discussion we had about shoes. But what was strange to me was not really the message, but the fact that I would actually write a URL address in the letter. You can't click on this thing. So, but that's the way I was sort of, it's like this is that URL address went to this little image that was on my website that was that pair of shoes painted by Wayne Thiebaud that sort of looked like the shoes I was talking about. But these kind of things are slipping into my work, and meanwhile in my studio, one more collage. This one says, just really quickly, I think this is a something that's just interesting to me. There's certain generations and certain artists mean a lot to certain generations. So he was like he's completely obsessed with cocooning. And I think if you're a certain generation, that's the case. Like that is the artist. So it says, what does it say here? It says, a model can take many different poses, but the only thing that counts is how it sits on the paper. So I draw why she lives on the paper. And then I made this thing. It's like, I would like to live here. And it's this little collage you made. That's a Martin Puryear sculpture and a Tony Smith model. And it was based on this H.C. Westerman, another great artist that I sort of am riffing off of.